Today we're going to learn about setting up layouts in your CMS4 software. Today we're going to look at layouts and how they affect the way you use CMS4 software. We're going to show you how to set up a few layouts to make it easier to make the CMS4 software work for you. Keep in mind, everything in our CMS4 software is completely customizable, and that's what I'm here for, is to show you how to customize it and make this software work the best for you. We're going to start by going to Enter Administrator Mode at the top, and that's going to allow us to adjust each of the layouts that's on your screen. So now if we look at the layouts on the screen, we can click through. These are the auto-generated layouts that it creates based on the number of cameras that we have access to with the user account that you're connected in from. So it will kind of auto-set a bunch of different layouts. I'm just going to go through and delete a bunch of these layouts because really they're not useful to me. And I'm going to create some layouts that I'm going to use instead because they'll be organized and named the way I want them. So I'm going to delete each one, just right-clicking on it and selecting delete, and you'll see them removed from the list. Don't worry, if you ever needed to get these back, you could simply remove the connection to your server, enter in the connection info again, and it will recreate all of those. The only one I'm going to hang on to is the 36 camera one that has all of the cameras that my user has access to. So I'm going to hang on to that, and I'm actually going to rename it all cameras because that makes more sense to me than looking at it and seeing 36 cameras. And now I'm going to move that up to the top so it's always at the top of the screen, and I know that's always going to show me all of the cameras. This layout I like as well, and maybe this is one front of building. So when I look at that, I'll know exactly what it is that I'm looking at. Now for some of the other layouts, we can create a new layout by right-clicking on the name of our DVR from the list, and then go to Add Global Layout, select Standard Layouts. The other ones kind of end up squashing the cameras a little bit. You can play around with them if you want, but I usually end up going to the standard layouts because it keeps cameras kind of in a better form factor. And then as you look down, it'll show you the number of cameras in each of those layouts. So you can create a bunch of different layouts to suit whatever your needs are. So if I wanted 13 cameras, one bigger one in the center with a bunch on the outside, now I can create that layout. It's added it into my list. And maybe I want to call this one outside of building. Because now instead of just the front, we're going to cover the entire outside. But maybe I want to restructure where the cameras are. All I did was click and drag. As long as you're in administrator mode, it'll swap the position of those cameras. So you can drag them around so they make best sense to you location wise. So I might go like this because I know this car and that car are the same, and then this entrance and that entrance and this entrance are the same. So I'm going to watch a vehicle travel up on that side. Maybe across the top I have the two views across the front, and then down the side of the building, this is the other side. So I'm going to wrap that over here so a vehicle will come off of this screen, go onto that screen. And then I can add in any cameras that aren't in view by going to the servers tab and pulling down. And this is where naming your cameras is very important because it makes it easier for you to find them out of the list. So now that we've got the list of cameras there, I can say, I know that there's another camera up that side of the building that isn't on screen as of yet. And that should be our Northwest 2, and then that runs from there into there. Then I can see those cameras that I want to see going all across the building in the direction that makes best sense for me, so that I can see where vehicles are coming from or to, or where people are coming from or to. you can drag those in from the side using that servers tab on the bottom. You can also drag back and forth on the screen. Now, last, I might want to get a different view in the center here. So I may grab even one of the same camera if I wanted to and set it to a higher quality stream since it's a larger view. I can even have that same camera displayed twice on my layout if I want to. Then you could zoom in on a certain area on one of those as you get to some of the advanced techniques. But once you've arranged your cameras the way you want to see them, then we can go back to our layouts list and move this layout around to wherever you're going to use it. Layouts are very, very useful, and look at some of our advanced videos to see how creating a layout, even just to play back a certain incident, can help save you time just by quickly creating that layout. This was a video on customization of the CMS4 software and doing some basic work with layouts. Stay tuned for more videos showing you more on how you can work with the software and get more out of your security camera systems.